बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू एवरीवन। मी दिया शहजादी, वेलकम इन द कैम बूस्टर चैनल। ओके, लेट्स मूव टूवर्ड्स आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर। अकॉर्डिंग टू द फंडामेंटल केमिस्ट्री, दिस इज द पार्ट ऑफ द फंडामेंटल केमिस्ट्री। इन द बेसिकली इट्स बिलोंग्स फ्रॉम द केमिकली स्पीशीज। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग दैट द आयंस मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑल आर द केमिकली स्पीशीज। There are further more types of the molecules. We know molecule is what is the molecule and its properties, its contributions toward any reaction and the any mechanism. Okay, molecule. A molecule is formed by the chemical combinations of the atoms. It is the smallest unit of the substance. It shows the properties of a substance and can exist independently. It is the property of a molecule that it can exist independently and have a specific properties of any substance, that is belong to molecule. We know what are the molecules. Carbon dioxide is a molecule, water is a molecule, the compound, basically the compounds that are formed by the two element or the two or more atoms, these are the molecules. In this slide I am telling you the different types of the molecules. There are the different types of the molecule that are just behind, depends upon the number of the atoms that are combining in the molecule, that is in the formation of a molecule. When a molecule is formed, what are the number of molecules or the atoms that are combining in the reaction? Okay, and the, as a result, what will be the name we assign to the molecules that are formed by the combination of the different atoms? Monoatomic molecules, diatomic molecules, triatomic molecules, polyatomic and the homoatomic molecules. Okay, now moves towards the monoatomic. Monoatomic, as its name says, that the mono is will be consist of a single atom, only one atom. A molecule consists of only one atom is called the monoatomic molecule. Here is the, there are a few examples like the inert gases like a helium, He. He is its abbreviation for the helium and it's a single molecule. Like it can exist in the form of the helium, not He plus 2 या कुछ भी, इसके साथ कोई भी साइन नहीं होगा, it will exist independently. And the neon and the argon that are also the noble gases, because due to they have the complete octet and non-reactive gases basically. Now moves toward the diatomic molecule. If a molecule consists of the two atom, it is called the diatomic molecules. Here are the few examples. Here is the hydrogen. Hydrogen is just abbreviated as a H. Oxygen is abbreviated for the O and chlorine is abbreviated for the Cl. But in the case of the diatomic molecule, the hydrogen will exist in the form of the H2 gas, that is the hydrogen gas, and the oxygen will exist in the form of the O2, that is the oxygen gas, and the chlorine will be exist in the form of the Cl2, that is the chlorine gas. And HCl, hydrochloric acid, that is the basically formed by the two combination of the two atoms. H is a hydrogen and the chlorine is from the chlorine. Triatomic molecules, it consists of a three atoms, it is called the triatomic molecules. Here are the few examples like that for the triatomic molecules. Water is basically, water is a molecule, but here it is formed by the combination of the three atoms. We are taking the two hydrogen atom. At the same time, we are taking only single atom of the oxygen to form the triatomic molecule, that is the basically triatomic molecule of a hydrogen. Same wise, carbon dioxide, as we can see, here are the two atoms are the two elements, but the ratio is different. Carbon is a single atom, but the oxygen is in the combination form, in the form of the molecule. So that's why it is called the triatomic molecule. Okay, now moves towards the next slide, that is the polyatomic. In the previous slide, we discussed only about the mono, dia and the tri. Now the polyatomic. Name says the poly will be the many, so many atoms or like the compounds are combined to form the polyatomic molecules. If a molecule consists of the many atoms, it is called the polyatomic. Here are the examples of the methane, sulfuric acid, glucose are the examples of the polyatomic molecule, because they are containing in the, we can say in the methane, here are the four hydrogen and the single or carbon atom that is forming the five. Basically, this is the combination of the five elements or the atoms to form a polyatomic molecules. Here the in the sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid, four oxygen, single sulfur and the two hydrogen atoms. In the glucose, six carbon, six hydrogen and the 11 groups, 11 atoms of the oxygen are combining to form the glucose. Homoatomic molecules. A molecule containing the same number, same atom of, same type of atom. This will be called the homoatomic molecule as the hydrogen gas, ozone O3, this is the ozone and the sulfur S and the phosphorus in the form of the single phosphorus P or the P4, P3, whatever. This is the homoatomic molecule. And the heteroatomic molecule, when a molecule consists of the different kind of the atoms, this will be called the heteroatomic molecules. And the example is the carbon dioxide, water molecule and the ammonia gas. Now, in the next slide, we were discussing the three most important formulas that are basically from the mole, derivative from the mole, that is the gram atomic mass, gram molecular mass and the gram formula mass. Gram atomic mass. What is the gram atomic mass? The quantity of the element, those mass expressed in a gram is numerically equal to the atomic mass is given or is known as the gram atomic mass. 1 mole of a carbon dioxide or a single carbon, this will be equal to the 1 gram atom of the carbon, that is the atomic number of the carbon is what is a 12. Atomic mass of the carbon is, atomic number is 6, but atomic mass jo hai carbon dioxide ka, simple carbon ka, that is the 12. And for the hydrogen it's a 1.008 gram and for the carbon it's a 12 gram. Gram molecular mass. Gram molecular mass is a mass in a gram of 1 mole of a molecular substance. If we are taking the 1 molecular substance and 1 mole of the molecular substance, then its mass in a gram will be equal to the gram molecular mass of that substance. Gram molecular mass is the same as the molar mass because it's a molar mass na. When gram of anything, this is the molar mass and molar mass is what is a molecular mass. Basically, we can say this, okay, it's a molecular mass. Gram molecular mass may be represented in the grams or the grams per mole. That is the molar mass. That is denoted by the capital M. That is the M divided by N is equal to gram. This is the unit and derived from the formula. That is the mass. Mass is given in the form of the grams and the number of moles are given in the forms of mole. And it is also called mole. For example, 1 mole of a water is equal to the 1 gram molecule of the 18 gram. We know that the hydrogen is a 1, its atomic mass 1 and the oxygen is 16. Here in the water molecule, there are the 2 hydrogen atoms and the 1 single atom of the oxygen, that is the single oxygen will contain the 16 number and the 2 hydrogen will make it the 18 number. And 1 gram molecule of the water will contain the gram molecular mass of the 18 gram. As the hydrogen atom. Hydrogen atom, 1 molecule of a hydrogen atom will contain the 2. Hydrogen atom ki baat ho rahi hai. 1 mole. Then this will be contain the 2 hydrogen atoms. And as well as the sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid will contain the molecular gram formula or the molecular gram mass will be equal to the 98 gram. Gram formula mass. Basically, gram formula mass is considered for the ionic compound that are formed by the ionization or the cationic or the inionic reaction that are occurring in a reaction, that is called the gram formula mass. When the ionic compound formula mass is expressed in a gram, then it is called the formula mass, and formula mass is also known as a mole. 1 mole of the carbon calcium carbonate is equal to the 1 gram formula of the calcium carbonate, that is the 100 gram. Here the calcium is the mass of the 20, carbon is 12, as well as the oxygen is the 16. Here the oxygen number are 3, then we will multiply the 16 with the 3 times and then add up the 12 plus 20, then that will be equal to the 100 grams of this. Okay, as well as we can say the sodium chloride 1 mole it will be equal to the 1 formula unit of the NaCl, and this will be equal to the 58.5 gram. Okay, this is the most favorite part, the quiz. It's a quiz for you guys. You have to just read this. There are the simple straight questions with the I read them. All the questions are the what are the types of the moles and is the gram formula mass is equal to the 1 mole of any substance? Yes, this answer will be yes. And why we use the gram atomic mass for the element and the gram formula for the ionic compound? There should be a reasoning answer. So good luck to all. Thank you. Take care of yourself and never forget to subscribe my channel. Take care of yourself and others. Allah Hafiz.